school days used to be quite busy and active. I would wake up early, get ready and go to work. I worked for an IT services company. The days where I used to manage to come back home early, I would try and get some quality time in with my son. Maybe play with him, help him with some homework. Generally, that's how active my days were until this unexpected event happened.
Aarti Narasimhan was 40 years old when she first noticed a painless lump in her breast during self-examination. After a series of tests, Aarti was diagnosed with breast cancer, and it changed the course of her life.
Interestingly, the mammogram itself was indicating a benign lump, you know. But when he did the ultrasound, immediately I could actually visibly see his body language changing. And that was the beginning of, the trouble for me. So I'm like, what happened? So he says, this doesn't look good. And I said, what do you mean it doesn't look good? And he says, I do believe. I said, what do you think? He said, I do believe this is malignant. And that was it. I just burst out into tears.
Cancer is the result of alteration of genes responsible for the growth of the cells in the body. This abnormal proliferation, when it occurs in breast cells, is referred to as breast cancer.
Breast cells are dependent upon the estrogen. So when there is estrogen, it divides the breast cells. But if there is an excess of estrogen, or if there is an unopposed estrogen, then the cell division within the breast increases, and that kind of feeds to the formation of breast cancer. If they notice any lump in the breast or in the armpit or any skin discoloration, like there's redness in the skin, or if there's any retraction of the nipple, or if there's any discharge from the nipple, say like bleeding or white discharge from the nipple, those are the warning signs that people have to look for. So when she came in, she was somewhat confused in one sense, like, okay, I know that I have this tumor, which is not very big. But they also, on the ultrasound and the mammogram, they told me that I have the lymph nodes, whether I should go for a lumpectomy with a lymph node dissection or a mastectomy.
The decision about the surgery was not an easy task for Aarti. A lot had to be planned for the post-surgery care at home. It was the unflinching support of her family members that helped Aarti battle through this rough stretch of her life.
Every single person was there for me through thick and thin. My sister lived in the US. She made two trips. Once she left, her baby was just 2 years old, and she came. She was with me during chemotherapy. She went back, and again she came back and stayed through the radiation with me.
In October 2014, Aarti mustered the courage to go under the knife to remove the cancerous cells.
Maybe 20, 30 years ago, people did the mastectomy, which is basically removing the whole breast and the lymph nodes. And then subsequently what they found is removing the lump alone, just the cancer and the surrounding areas, along with the lymph nodes without removing the whole breast, is as good as removing the breast completely. And in the lumpectomy, the amount of tissue removed is very minimal, and the key thing will be for the surgeon to see whether they can maintain the architecture of the breast so that there is no major cosmetic issues. In the mastectomy, they remove the breast completely, so the entire breast is removed, and subsequently either they go in, younger patients, they go in for reconstruction immediately after the surgery, or some of them go for reconstruction after completion of all the treatments.
My surgeon is like, oh, so where is the problem? So which side is the problem? So I was like, he said, don't worry, these are standard questions we need to ask. I said, I have no issues with whatever, as long as you treat the right side, I'm fine if you treat the left side as well. So we just kind of joked about it and stuff. And the next thing I knew, the surgery was over, and they were trying to talk to me saying, the surgery is over, and they were trying to wake me up before wheeling me down.
The next two levels of treatment were physically excruciating. But the warrior in Aarti found solace by practicing mindfulness meditation during her multiple sessions of chemotherapy and radiation therapy. It was also during this period that Aarti is born with her sister-in-law, Bruce Tonga. Tanya's act of solidarity brought them even closer.
The main reason that I did it was because of her son Aryan. I knew he would be really, really devastated. He would be really upset to see his mother lose her hair. I realized that, you know, it's fine. It's hair, it's going to grow back. So we kind of made it like a fun activity with, you know, including the children and my brother as well. He also did it. Everybody was in a very laughing and joking mood, and, you know, then we shaved off her hair.
People need a lot of motivation. Come over the chemotherapy, because it does have a lot of, it affects the whole body when you give the chemotherapy. It affects all the fat growing cells. So the hair falls off and they don't have the taste. So the food tastes differently for different persons and they don't feel like eating. And they are tired, even though the tiredness is not very much, but it does affect your day-to-day activities. And then comes the radiation. Radiation is usually used if number of lymph nodes involved are more, or the size of the tumor is more than 5 centimeters, or if the skin is involved significantly. Those are the people who undergo the radiation.
After undergoing the treatment for a few months, Aarti started doing simple arm and shoulder exercises at home. By doing this diligently, she has been able to gradually restore mobility and strength in her upper limb. But there are still some limitations that she can't overlook for the rest of her life.
I have to make sure that she does not get the swelling of the arm, which means like going through the physical therapy and doing the exercises so that her hand does not fall into the category of getting a massive lymphedema. She cannot lift heavy weights on the right side. Avoid using a lot of pressure. She should avoid or restrict the number of calories one takes and restrict the fatty food. And there are people who do suggest like restricting the dairy products. So we have recommended that she restricts her dairy products.
At present, Aarti is back to leading her usual busy life. She goes for her routine checkups and follows her doctor's instructions. Life seems to have come a full circle for her.
I work in a large company, over 100,000 people, and we had a company-wide contest for ideas, for value generation. And one of my entries, one of my ideas, was actually shortlisted. And then we had to go through this series of steps. Basically, we were shortlisted various rounds with various senior people in the company. And I was actually preparing for that through simultaneously as I was taking treatment. So it kept me focused, it kept me motivated and engaged and enthused about coming back full force to work as well.
Aarti never made her health condition look grim. She kept a positive mindset throughout the treatment and allowed her faith to carry her through. Aarti Narasimhan is much braver than she ever imagined herself to be.
Hello everybody, I'm here to give you an update on Mr. Amitabh Ghosh. He was detected, as all of you know, with a tumor in his gastroesophageal junction. But because of precise detection and treatment, he's now completely free of the disease. Mrs. Aarti was detected with a lump in her breast. Currently, she's on oral medications with no evidence of the disease. She's leading a normal life, working in a multinational company. Folks, this is important. Indians are increasingly susceptible to incidences of cancer. It is very, very important for all of you to understand all of the root causes and possible treatment options. This is especially important for breast cancer, given that it is the most common cancer among women. For all of the viewers out there that are above 40, please do not hesitate to consult an oncologist if you sense something is amiss. Early detection is key. Stay cautious, stay healthy. Until we meet next week in Let's Talk Health, goodbye for now.